Shalom. Peace and blessings, beloved. There's so much information and conversation going on about the death and passing of Kobe Bryant, his daughter, and the six other people. I'm sorry, the seven other people on board. I was going to say something yesterday and make a video, but then it was so much information coming out and so many people saying things that this thought came to my mind. The Spirit spoke to me, and this scripture just kept coming. So today, I want to share it. We're in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 12. I'm going to speak throughout Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, but I'm starting at the 12th verse. For man also knoweth not his time. No man knows the day, the hour of his death. For man also knoweth not his time, as the fishes that are taken in an evil net, and as the birds that are caught in the snare, so are the sons of men snared in an evil time, when it falleth suddenly upon them. Death is one of those punches that no matter how many times we experience it, be it somebody we know about vicariously through their celebrity, through their skills, or somebody we're close to, it's shocking, especially when it comes suddenly. But the Word of God tells us that that's exactly what can happen. For man also knoweth not his time. God knows. A man does not know. As the fishes that are taken in the evil net, and as the birds that are caught in the snare, so are the sons of men snared in an evil time. What's an evil time? It's a situation that you can't get out of. It happens so quickly without warning. It's an evil time. No amount of money. It doesn't matter how you look. It doesn't matter who you belong to, what you're doing, unfinished business, unbeknownst to you, it's done. God knows, but man does not know. I'm going up one, reading chapter 11, verse 11. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise, nor riches to the men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happeneth to them all. To them all. I listen to many people talk about, but he had so much going on. One of the things this makes us recognize is our own mortality, and the fact that it doesn't matter rich, poor, male, female, famous, or only known by those that know you closely. You got to get your house in order, brothers and sisters. Believe in your heart, Jesus Christ came to this earth, sent by God, died for sinners, rose from the grave, sits on the right hand of God. Believe in your heart that you shall be saved. And you shall be saved. Believe it, confess it with your mouth. Believe in your heart. You don't know when that snare is going to come. You don't know. You may lay in your bed and sleep away. Grow old. But remember, time and chance happen to us all. I listen to so many people. The news is flooded. Everybody acts shocked. But one of the last things Yeshua HaMashiach said is the last enemy, because he's an enemy. It doesn't matter whether we're talking about somebody famous or we're talking about somebody close to you. Death has a sting that there's really, it's indescribable the effect it has on people's lives. People, we assume that we have tomorrow, but remember, for man also knoweth not his time. You don't know when God's going to call you home. And no man can discharge that call. No man has the power. When I say man, excuse me, man, I mean man or woman. Boy, girl, baby, It doesn't matter. And money cannot save us. It cannot save us. The only salvation we have is through Jesus Christ, believing in Him, confessing Him, and we shall be saved. We have to use our faith. It makes you feel your own mortality. It makes you recognize how delicate this life really is and how quickly you can transition from one space in life to another. It makes you recognize how delicate the lives of others are, as well as your own. It doesn't matter how much money you have in the bank. When that time comes, chance and circumstance happens to us all. What happens to the rich happens to the poor. What happens to the strong happens to the weak. What happens to one happens to the other. It doesn't matter what color you are. It doesn't matter what job you work at, if you work at all. Chance and circumstance happens to us all. But death, we all are going to have to give an account. But that blood of the Lamb on us, that's the account we want to give. Because we don't know when that hour is going to come. No man knows the hour. He cometh like a thief. When you think about it, death is a thief. Death is a thief. It takes away all hopes and dreams. It doesn't matter what the plan was, it's over. It doesn't matter who's waiting for you. You're never coming back. But if you accept Yeshua HaMashiach as your Lord and Savior, if you believe it in your heart, confess it with your mouth, you shall be saved. God is faithful when He said, you shall be saved. And understand, hear these words in Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 12. For man also knoweth not his time. You don't know the day of your death. You don't know the hour. The brother, his friends, his children, his child, and the children on board, they were going on one journey in their mind, but there was another journey waiting. Why? For man also knoweth not his time. As the fishes that are taken in an evil net, you moving along doing what you do and without warning. And as birds that are caught in a snare, so are the sons of men snared in an evil time, when it falleth suddenly, where there's no recovering from it. So, brothers and sisters, remember the race isn't to the swift. No, it's not. Nor the battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise. Nor yet riches to men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skills, but time and chance happeneth to them all, to them all. All means everybody. There are so many people that are shocked. I think it's beautiful that people are paying tribute, but I also want to pay tribute to people that are not known, to people's family and friends and loved ones that you're not going to hear about them, but there's some broken hearts out here because time and chance happens to us all, to us all. But what can we do? There's going to come a day. Oh, yes, it is. There shall be no more tears, no more sorrow, no more separation, no more pain, and most of all, no more death. God said it, His word goes out, does not come back. You be encouraged, brothers and sisters, that whether we meet on this side or the other, that as long as you believe in Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, you accept Him as your Savior, you believe in your heart, you confess it with your mouth, use your faith, trust in God. We witness death. We witness the events of life every day. Every day. As living proof, and it is still happening, caught in an evil snare. In an evil snare. Man knows not his time, believe me. Many people that have gone out to do one thing or expected one result and got a completely different result on this side of eternity, in this terrestrial realm, Never knew. You get ready to hit the pure spiritual realm. You believe, you trust, and you confess. Yeshua is the Son of God. Believe He is your Lord and Savior. Believe it in your heart, confess it with your mouth, and you shall be saved. You shall. Some people think they can put it off to tomorrow, but tomorrow is not promised. 5 minutes from now is not guaranteed. You can blink and just be gone. But at least you get the peace of knowing that God's word, it does not go out and come back. Brothers and sisters, I just kept thinking about like fish caught in a net. Man does not know his time. And he's caught in a snare. We see. It doesn't matter how much money you have. This is not the first time we've seen these events. Many of us, most of us, if not all of us that are watching, we live long enough to have seen things like this before. Car accident, somebody fell down the steps. They went in the hospital for one thing and was supposed to come out, and the next thing you know, you're going to a funeral. Somebody lay down and did not wake up. Sometimes they weren't even sick. They just died of natural causes and they're in their 20s. And you're like, what are you talking about? A sweet little baby. You put them down to sleep, perfect will of health, and they just sleep right on the way into the arms of God. Believe in your heart. Confess it with your mouth. Jesus is the Son of God, Yeshua HaMashiach. Believe He is your Lord and Savior. Confess Him and you shall be saved. There's no need to feel ashamed. None of us can brag or boast. None of us are without sin. But we get the peace of knowing that if that snare catches us suddenly, and we cannot, that's that sudden snare. The Word of God is telling us there's no escape. Top man does not know his time when his time is gone. But at least we get the peace of knowing. We're going to go to a place death can't enter in. We're going to live in a realm, sickness, sadness, sorrow, pain will be forgotten. This life is temporary. This terrestrial. We're going to change. In the twinkling of an eye, it comes like a thief. And you can see how he comes like how it comes and takes people away. People that you thought were pillars in your life, and suddenly they're removed. And you who were leaning on them are suddenly the pillar of somebody else's life. You be at peace, brothers and sisters. I just wanted to share this. I'm going to say it again because it was on my heart. Ecclesiastes 9:12. For man also knoweth not his time. God knows. God knows. And that's why you can't waste time. You can't put off till tomorrow what you can do right now, which is accept Yeshua, Jesus Christ, as your Lord and Savior. Confess it with your mouth. Believe in your heart. He is the Son of God. He died for sinners like us and He rose. You confess Him before men. He confesses you before the Most High God. You shall be saved. You shall be saved. For man also knoweth not his time. We don't know our time. As the fishes that are taken in an evil net, and as the birds that are caught in a snare, so are the sons of men, men and women, boys and girls, babies, snared in an evil time. When it falleth suddenly upon him, there's no recovery, there's no time to prepare. It falleth suddenly. But you get the peace of knowing. I'm trusting, I'm believing. And God will work it out. You be at peace, brothers and sisters. Be encouraged. And it's good to think about your mortality. Better to be in a house of mourning than a house of mirth. There is a season to everything. This is a season of reflection. This is a season of, if you haven't got your life right, this is your hour, this is your moment. Believe it, confess it. You shall be saved. Jesus is the Son of God. He came down to this earth to save sinners. And if you believe and you confess, you shall be saved. He died, rose from the grave after 3 days, and now sits on the right hand of power. Be encouraged. Shalom.